for them, and they will be thrown in hell fire. And such sinner will not find anybody to help them there. Before I leave this stage, I would like to thank Allah, then my mother Nida, who alone taught me this knowledge at home. I pray Allah, the only God, to help my father, Mr. Imran, to convey the truth of Quran to all of you. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakumullahu khaira. After watching the wonderful presentation by these children, one can understand how important is the involvement of the mother in training the children in the right perspective. Because it is popularly believed that the mother is the first school of the children. MashaAllah, all these children are doing very well in their academics too. And the credit of their credibilities goes to their mother, sister Nida. In fact, IREF is planning to establish an Islamic school with international academic standards where children are taught contemporary branches of education in compatibility with the glorious Quran as well as in compatibility with the life of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in understanding and methodology of Sahaba Akram Razi Allahu Ta'ala Anhum Ajma'in. For the same, IREF invites any philanthropist and the generous people to come forward and support this educational project undertaken by IREF in order to safeguard the Islamic and academical values of our children. Inshallah, we shall now begin our main session. As proposed by Pastor Ranjit Ofir and accepted by Brother Imran, I shall be the master of conduct of this evening's session. As such, on behalf of IREF, Islamic Research and Educational Foundation, and RKP, Rashtriya Kraistav Parishad, I, Muhammad Mehboob Ali, popularly called Mansoor, welcome all of you to witness an educational debate between Pastor Ranjit Ofir and Brother Imran on the topic, the Bible or the Quran, which is the God's word. Pastor Ranjit Ofir, during the correspondence, generously offered to Brother Imran to share the financial expenses of this debate. And Brother Imran reciprocated to Pastor Ofir by thanking him for the offer of the financial support. But Brother Imran said that IREF will take only the name of RKP as combined organizers along with IREF so as to send across the message amongst the masses that we can share our differences yet be peaceful towards each other. And IREF alone will take the responsibility of all the financial aspects and event management of this debate. IREF and RKP became the combined organizers of this debate in this aspect. MashaAllah, IREF and RKP as combined organizers of this debate feel proud to be living in a beautiful country like India, whose soil has a pluralistic society and where the law of our land, India, provides us a fair provision to peacefully gather people and discuss the points of agreement and disagreement without forcing our opinion upon each other and being justified by discussing the subject with evidences. Respecting the law of this land, India, I request all of you not to get emotional or sentimental and then react in a way that may invite unnecessary problems for your illegal behavior. Slogans are strictly prohibited. Being the master of conduct of this session, I am authorized to add or amend any of the above rules. Now, I invite Pastor A. Ranjit Ofir, President RKP to come on the stage. Now I request Brother Imran, President IREF, to come on the stage. First, I shall introduce Pastor Ranjit Ofer to all of you. Pastor Ranjit Ofer is a student of electronics and was employed in ECIL from 1977 to 1980. In February 1980, God called him to the work of evangelism. He resigned his job and started to preach the gospel with the trust in the Almighty God alone. He is the founder president of Agape Full Gospel Ministries and RKP, Rashtriya Kraistava Parishad. In his 20 years of evangelism, Pastor Ofer has established more than 300 churches in the states of Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Orissa. He is the author of many Christian theological books and is well known as the editor of a Christian monthly magazine, Omega Swaram. Pastor Ofer maintains the pedigree of having a deep proof into almost of all the scriptures of Islam, Zoroastrianism, Plato, Confucianism, Buddhism, Vedas, besides a thorough proof into the Bible, having read it for all 114 times. Pastor Ofer is a well-known Christian apologist. He has taken part in many public inter-religious debates. Pastor Ofer had public debates with Muslim brothers in Kakinada, Hyderabad, and other places. He believes that it is possible with God's help to discover the ultimate truth through inter-religious debates. He is a man of love and patience. He is able to teach and is willing to learn. His disciples call him with love in the regional language of Andhra Pradesh as E Taramu Paulu, meaning the Paul of this generation. So that was Pastor Ranjit Ofer. Now I shall introduce Brother Imran to all of you. Mujtaba Hussain Siddiqui, popularly known as Brother Imran, is a student of BA Public Administration from Nizam College, Hyderabad. He was employed in Riyadh, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, in mid-90s. During this period, the legend of modern-day Dawah, Sheikh Ahmed Didat, was admitted in Riyadh Hospital for treatment. Being introduced for the first time and impressed at the first sight, Brother Imran started to visit Sheikh Ahmed Didat regularly. Although Sheikh Didat could not speak as he was paralyzed, but yet, lying sick on the bed, still his personality had the grace of Allah to motivate Brother Imran to resign his job in an American firm and return back to India for good and become a full-time Dai. He founded IREF, Islamic Research and Educational Foundation, in February 1998, as a government-registered, non-profit, charitable, educational society. Hitherto, Brother Imran had delivered several public talks and participated in inter-religious debates and dialogues on Islam and comparative religion in various parts of Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and other places in India. He also delivered international talks in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and America. MashaAllah, Sheikh Ahmed Didat sent a letter of appreciation in May 2004.
The hand action. I was very moved, Alhamdulillah.
These are the small Didats of India.
This guy is creating monsters for these people.
This guy, look at him with his fingers. He's quoting.
We're proud of Imran. We are proud of you, Brother Imran. We are very proud of you.
So these guys.
My father is alive to witness these tapes. That's why my father is alive.
With his thumb impression to Brother Imran, for his efforts in the field of Dawah. This is a copy of the letter that was sent to Brother Imran in May 2004 by Sheikh Ahmad Didad. In this letter addressing Brother Imran, he said, "Dear son Imran, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Your debate, my son, is giving Muslims and non-Muslims exposure to the true message of the Holy Quran. I am happy to see you that you have gained so much confidence in discussing comparative religion. Keep up your great mission. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to bless you and make you true and strong for many years to come. Ameen. Pray for me as I pray for you. Ahmad Hussein Didad, dictated via communication board." So this was the letter that was sent to Brother Imran in appreciating the work that he has taken up. Brother Imran had trained more than 100 students in the field of Dawah who are delivering talks at various places on Islam and comparative religion, either in the capacity of being attached at IREF or supporting other upcoming Dawah organizations in Hyderabad and outside. Brother Imran is appreciated for his convincing answers in compatibility with the glorious Quran and authentic ahadith, as well as comparative religion, logic and scientific explanations. So this is Brother Imran. As advertised, we shall toss a coin between Pastor Ranjit Ofir and Brother Imran, and the winner of the toss will announce the format to me, and in turn I shall announce the format to the audience. Ofir is for heads. Bismillah. As decided by both the speakers, as they have agreed, the entire debate will be conducted in four sessions. The first speaker of the first session will be Brother Imran for 30 minutes. Then Pastor Ofir will speak for equal time, that is 30 minutes. After a short pause, we will have the second session. The first speaker of the second session will be Pastor Ofir for 15 minutes, followed by Brother Imran for 15 minutes. And in the third session, Pastor Ofir will speak for 15 minutes, followed by Brother Imran's response for 15 minutes. Finally, we shall be having the question and answer session. When 5 minutes are left for the respective speakers to conclude their speeches in the allotted time, I shall stand up and sit down to indicate that they have to conclude their speech in 5 minutes. And when only 1 minute is left to conclude the session, I should stand continuously till the end. If the speaker exceeds his allotted time, then being the master of conduct and to maintain a justified decorum of the session, I have the authority to interrupt the speech and force the speaker to conclude immediately. Now, I request Brother Imran, the founder president of IREF, Islamic Research and Educational Foundation, to present his talk for 30 minutes. Brother Imran.
Alhamdulillahi wahda. والصلاه والسلام على من لا نبي بعد وعلى اله واصحابه اجمعين اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وان منهم لفريقا يلون السنتهم بالكتاب لتحسبوه من الكتاب وما هو من الكتاب ويقولون هو من عند الله وما هو من عند الله ويقولون على الله الكذب وهم يعلمون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Christian scholar Pastor Ranjit Ofir, respected Master of Conduct Brother Mansoor, respected elders in the audience, and all my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The topic of this evening's debate is the Bible or the Quran. Which is the God's word? A common man might answer this question, which is the God's word, by either replying that I think that both Bible and the Quran are the God's word, or he might say that both Bible and the Quran are not the God's word, or he might say that only Bible is the God's word. Or he might say, only Quran is the God's word. As a Muslim, sincerely adhering to the original standards of all evidences, I proclaim proudly that Quran is the only 100% verbatim word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to give any answer except the answer I gave or the option I selected, to believe any other scripture to also be the God's word would be as wrong as believing the